common colors you'll see are going to be your German slider styles. You have your American coupler for your domestic cakes. And you have your European for your imported cakes. And the difference are the size and the reach of the actual coupler. You're going to have faceted in your hoses these metal nibbles that are held on by a hex screw, and that also is what attaches onto the coupler. You'll have a washer inside there and then a rubber gauge for your CO2 line. Here we see the adjacent female counterparts to the couplers, and we do have a lot of different couplers. Some I haven't even seen myself, but I just showed you the examples of the most common. The first step in changing any type of coupler is to turn off your CO2 system. And when you're going to be replacing a coupler, we're working with a classic American coupler. You always want to distinguish your difference in lines. We have our beer line and our CO2 line. Sometimes these are the same color. In most cases, you're going to see your red one for your gas line. As I showed you in the coupler video, we're going to be having these guys already fastened into the hoses. And the first thing that you want to do is you're going to attach our beer line. So you want to make sure we have a rubber washer. It's going to go into our beer line. We're going to take our coupler and we are going to screw it in nice and tightly. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to take our gas hose nipple, we're going to place it into the metal coupling, and then we're going to screw that guy on nice and tight. Now what we're going to be doing is we're going to be putting this, you'll see the divots in the keg right here and right here. We're going to be lining them up, lightly pushing, turning clockwise, and locking it into place. And now we're good to have a fresh, cool pint. There may be a buildup of pressure remaining in your keg lines, so you want to have a few seconds of beer flow before putting your glass in at a 150 degree angle and slowly leveling your glass with the beer. You want to hold the handle at the base, and you always want to avoid having the actual tap submerged in the beer. And perfection. A big part of craft beer service is knowing your beer and guiding your guests. The Duck Rabbit Amber Ale is a good alternative to someone looking for a fat tire. The Hemp Brown Ale is an American brown ale that's comparable to an English, to something like a Newcastle. We also have a UFO Raspberry, which would be nice for the usual Blue Moon drinker and also maybe someone looking for a lambic. The Blue Point Toasted Lager is great for a Yingling drinker. And the Peak Organic Fresh Cut is actually a dry hopped pilsner that would be nice for an IPA drinker. If someone's looking for a refreshing light beer, the Big Rock Coconut is wonderful, maybe a little bit sweet. And we have, for the stout and porter drinker, a Wake Up Coffee Blonde Ale, which is great for hot weather. And for someone who is a cider drinker or a non-beer drinker looking for something sweet, the Ace Pineapple is an interesting take on that.